Okay, so this last one is a question, and this comes up in Christian atheist debates. Why is there something rather than nothing? I mean, there must be, it seems like if there was no God, there would just be nothing. If you say there was a Big Bang that created everything, what made the Big Bang, or who made the Big Bang, they'll say. And if you can't explain it, then it looks like it's obvious evidence God did it. Have you heard these arguments?
Absolutely. You hear that a lot today, not just in religion, but with the fascination in our country today and around the world with paranormal things. I can't explain it, so it must be a ghost. So if you can't explain it, it must be God, or it must be something outside of the realm of humanity.
Mm-hmm.
I think with this, I wish I was, I'm not a physicist. I wish I had like Lawrence Krauss sitting here with me. But when you think about things like that, my thought is, why is there something from nothing? Well, how do we know there was ever nothing? And I know we can go back to, well, some people will believe there's a Big Bang, and some will believe, well, God just created. And before the Big Bang or before God created, there was nothing. But yet, nobody really knows that for sure. It's kind of an intangible thought. In fact, I love a quote, or not the quote, but the idea Stephen Hawking proposed it. He says, what is north of the North Pole? You can't put your hands on it or your mind around it.
Yeah, there is no such thing by definition, because that's the ultimate north.
Right, yeah. Right. And so with this thing, there's nothing. Well, when was there nothing? Well, before God created, there was nothing. Or
right.
Before the Big Bang, there was nothing. Or back in this time, there was nothing. Well, again, we don't know for 100%
right.
Fact there was ever nothing. What if there wasn't? And it's one of those things you can sit around and grab a coffee and talk about for days and just give yourself a headache thinking about it. But I think it's an incorrect argument that there's
mm-hmm.
a God because there's something. That just doesn't, you can't take
yeah.
that argument because you don't know when or where there was nothing.
Yeah, there is a logical fallacy that is called the argument from ignorance. Basically it says if you can't prove it, then that's evidence for God. The thing is, it's not evidence for anything. We can't say, it would be a logical fallacy to go either way. We can't say nobody knows, therefore someday we'll find out by science, or therefore God did it. It's, if you don't know, you don't know. That's all there is to it. You can't say nobody knows, therefore my point is correct.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times in debates, you'll hear the Christian hammer this home. They'll say like, well, how do you explain it? You don't, we are not able to explain it. Part of it is that this is also so complex too. When you think about, part of the Christian idea is that we are so brilliant that if we can't explain it, it must have been designed by a God. But when you look at it more humbly through scientific eyes, we used to think that space and time were two different things. And then Einstein said, no, these things are tied together. There's a space-time fabric. And I believe in string theory right now, which is unproven, but they think there's 11 dimensions.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't even know we can't even imagine what the fifth dimension might be. We can't even imagine it. We can't even imagine what a sixth dimension is or a seventh dimension, and here there might be 11 dimensions. And another thing, too, is they say that the universe, I believe, is like 95% dark energy and dark matter. And that means they call it dark because they don't even know what it is. It's like a placeholder. It's a variable in the equation. So most of the universe, we don't even know what it is. And here a Christian is saying, well, if you can't explain it, then obviously it's evidence for God. Essentially what they're saying is, if you can't explain it, then it's magic.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing I like to harp on is that there's a difference between magical thinking and scientific thinking. And the magical thinking is when you just put your brain on hold and it's like, well, how did the tree get here? Like my dad is famous for arguing with me constantly. Which came first, the chicken or the egg? And actually whenever I try to talk to him, he's just not able to grasp it. But he just wants to jump to, if you can't explain it, then the answer is magic. And this science, thank the gods of science, that people press on and find real answers. And we've learned that magic is not real. That's a profound statement. Magic is not real. I mean, a lot of people think even magicians are doing real magic. Or, even when they explain how this is how you do a magic trick, they go, well, that's neat, but how do you do real magic? You know, it's like there is no such thing as real magic. Magic is there, things just don't happen by magic.
Right. Well, I think you got a good point when you're talking about, especially like debating, and you say, "Well, I don't know," and then the other side would say, "Well, that's a point for me." You know, when you it's we have to, as a people, we have to learn. It's okay to say, "I don't know." We don't know everything. We can't know everything. And just because I don't know or can't know doesn't mean that there's a God. It just means I don't know. It's okay to say that. And that I was hard for me when I was going from being a believer to an unbeliever, because as a pastor, I couldn't say I don't know. It wasn't an acceptable answer. I had to find it out, or at least give credit to God. The point, if I don't know, like you said, I don't know, so it must be a God thing. But it's okay to say I don't know. And when it gets to something like a question like this, you know what? I don't know. I didn't listen in science class in school. I wish I had.
Well, even the
But
scientists don't know, so
right, it even goes beyond that. I
they
mean,
can't
even
explain where the Big
their
Bang came
realm.
from.
Correct. Yeah, it even goes beyond just, you know, a simple person like me that know. Even scientists say I don't know, and that's okay to say that. There's nothing wrong with saying I don't know.
And you know, the funny thing too is for a Christian to say, well, the answer is God, God did it, it's really not an answer. That's just basically saying there's somebody out there that's doing magic. That's all it's saying. It's like, who is this person? I mean, I think the funniest thing at all is to think, well, okay, imagine they're correct. There is some God out there that just made things by magic. It's like, where did this God come from? This God is supposed to be eternal. It's like, what a lucky fella just to look around and said, you know, as far as I can remember, I always existed. I didn't make myself. I don't know how I came to be or why I'm here, but I'm a lucky fella because, you know, here I am. And you know, God's
Yeah.
supposed to know everything, but yet he doesn't know how he came to be because he didn't make himself. The poor guy, he's confused on that one. How can he know everything? How can he
Well,
know how he came to be when he didn't create himself?
you kind of feel bad for God also when you go back to, we were talking earlier about, you know, Noah's Ark, when God created you know, the earth and people and everything, and then didn't realize that just 7 chapters further into his book he was going to have to destroy it all. So
Yeah,
I worry
it
about that
actually says
too.
in there he repented or he was sorry he made things. It's like, wait a minute, this guy was supposed to see everything coming before he even made it. He's supposed to be all knowing, and how could he regret that he made things?
I think one of the things that gets us into, I know it got me into the issues that I had, having to have questions and doubts, is when somebody would say, I don't know, or you're talking about something coming from nothing, and I would just instantly say, well, I don't know, so it's God. And eventually, I had grabbed so many things of our world and so many things of our universe that I started to say, okay, I've got all these things that people don't know, and I've given them to God, but you know what? There's more to this than I'm leading on, and I think that's what you get into here with what you, people just want to say. Okay, if nobody knows, we're going to give it to God.
Yeah.
Well, that's not fair for one, and two, it's probably, well, two, I know for a fact it's not right.
Yeah. And you know, it's just appealing to magic, you know, God's magic. You look up magic in the dictionary, it's, you know, doing things through supernatural powers. Like I said, thank the science gods for not falling for that and actually doing the hard work and progressing. All these things that were miracles before now can be explained. So,